that you could be to him, dear in any way, that a more absurd young girl has lived, I doubt that you could say. You, a favorite of Mr. Rochester, gifted with the power, your logic's beating by the hour, and to no avail, Jane, poor blind puppy, had to go on dreaming, had to try to give your life some meaning, still you fail, Jane. How dare you think there's a place in his heart for you? I'm painting my portrait, an absolute likeness, faithful to illustrate every fine line. I'm mastering detail, highlighting defects, making a permanent mirror to see all of the faults that lie hidden in me. I'm painting my portrait, it's plain and uneven, reminding me what I am, what I must be. I'm leaving out nothing, no matter how painful. All of my flaws on display to be seen. Now my painting is done, I'll start another, this one of her. And when I close my eyes, I clearly see her face, capture her grace and poise, fight back the tears. And I'm painting a portrait, an absolute likeness, the loveliest face, the most delicate skin, a tribute to beauty, the perfect Miss Ingram. Omit dye neither diamond ring nor golden rose. Make her a lady of rank, glistening satin. Oh, how she glows! Mixing your finest tints, paint her dramatically. With all your sweetest hues, sit here fanatically, painting your portraits. This one will live all of her life as a governess, just a lonely governess. This one will always be happy and marry a man who will carry her away. And should you fancy that he really loves you, just compare the pictures, two completely different mixtures. You should be ashamed, Jane. Why would he trade his silver for some unpolished metal? Why would he settle for a slave when he could have a queen? Jane is